It's time for the Freedom in 5 Minutes podcast. Powerful and liberating business strategies you can start in 5 minutes or less. Now, here's your host, Dean Soto.
Hey, this is Dean Soto, founder of ProSulum.com and FreedomIn5Minutes.com. And we're here again with another Freedom in 5 Minutes podcast episode. Today's topic is this. It's okay to work with only those you want to work with. That and more coming up. Well, good morning. We hear some hounds barking off in the distance. Man, they must, I wonder what they're barking at. Luna's looking. Luna, what's going on over there? It sounds like a ruckus. Over here in the country, we have ruckuses. And so I'm not sure what it is. But it might be actually a pack of dogs. You never know. Pack of wild dogs coming after me. Oh, no. Help me. Oh, cool. So, good morning. Good morning. Wow. Well, 2020 has proven to be a very good year so far. Business has boomed, which I'm very happy about. And one of the things that that has bred is, how do I want to say this, is the feeling or the ability to work with those I want to actually work with. So this should always be the case, but it's harder at times when things aren't going so well. All right, so here's the deal. So it was back in September. Back in September, this is not just this particular client, but back in September, I had a client who one of my business partners introduced me to. Super nice guy, still is a very nice guy, and he still is, at least as of recording this, is still a client. Super nice, but my brain just stopped, guys. So anyway, back in September, my business partner introduced me to this person who eventually ended up becoming a client. So we're talking with this person back in September, and what we do with our virtual systems architects, where you can take 5 minutes out of your day, just as if you were going to go make some coffee, or just if you were going to go and meditate or pray or read the Bible or do whatever it is that you do, 5 minutes a day. You can, if you spend those little 5 minutes creating a video, your dedicated virtual systems architect will then go document that whole thing that you just showed them, and then go and do it. And so this person works in a specific industry that where his clients that he's bringing into this particular industry, they have to create documented systems. They have to create documented processes. And often these guys are spending weeks, months, sometimes even years creating these documents, and then they become outdated and they have to do it all over again, right? When they could have been spending that time on much, much more important stuff, right? And so all that being said, The thing is, I just remind myself I need to do something today. Anyway, thank you, brain. So this when these people come into this industry, they have to do that. That is a big part of this industry, because if you don't, then you are going against a system. You know, it's the franchise industry, right? It's franchising in whether it's restaurant or whatever. You know, he's bringing people into certain franchises, and that is a huge, right? That is something that is that if you do not follow the system in a franchise, you potentially break not only the brand of the franchise, you can break your own stores and profitability. Because why do you buy a franchise in the first place? You buy into a franchise because it's a proven system, right? As long as the numbers are correct, as long as nobody's lying, you know exactly what numbers, you know the EBITDA, you know all that jazz, you know what you're getting into with these stores, right? So when you get into like a multi-unit franchise or whatever, you are looking at following the system and making the same amount of money, relatively the same amount of money. Well, as soon as you go against that, you are ruining the system. Like literally you are ruining the system because now you're doing something that's completely unproven. Sure, there are times where a franchisee has done something that has skyrocketed business, but that's very, very rare. And so if a franchisee wants to start using a different supply chain, or a franchisee wants to start using different marketing material, wants to set up their employee structure a different way, what do you think the franchisor, the person who owns the actual franchise, the actual brand, is going to do? They're going to say, no, don't do that. And if they keep on, if the franchisee keeps on asking questions or keeps on doing things that are against the franchise system, the franchisor is going to start flipping out, right? And so this particular client that we had, so we started back in September with them, sent them a draft agreement, showed them how long, you know, in the agreement it talks about how long it takes to get a virtual systems architect and all this other stuff. And every now and then, boom, they'd have some kind of worry that had already been addressed. And so eventually they ended up going dark for a while. They came back in around the December timeframe and said, okay, we're ready to go. Let's do this. And we resent them the draft agreement. And then they were like, why does it take 2 to 4 weeks to get a VSA? I wish you would have been more upfront about this with me. And I'm like, hello? We told you this. We sent you the same exact agreement. The same exact agreement in September. And it said the exact same thing. And we told you that's how long it takes. And didn't hear it from them for a little, I think it was like a week or whatever. And then all of a sudden it was like, all right, let's do this. And so they paid, they started moving forward. We actually found them a VSA like right away. In fact, I was kind of like to my guys, I'm like, why did you do that? Because we do have a queue of other people. But technically, the way my guys do it, this person was in the queue for a while because of back in September and the way they wanted to do it. I like the way my guys do things. I'm not going to ruin their little system that they've developed either. So anyway, so they go and, so he gets his VSA and part of what happens when someone gets a virtual systems architect is that they have to agree to follow our system. So they get an email saying, hey, welcome to the family. Here's what you're agreeing to if you choose to move forward. Otherwise, we're going to cancel and refund. I have no problem canceling and refunding. because I do not want to work with someone who's not going to follow the system, because it's going to tarnish my brand. It's going to, you know, imagine giving a Ferrari to somebody who's literally just going to drive down the block to get some milk and then come back, like, and letting them borrow the keys to your Ferrari for that. No, I'm not going to do that. I want to see that Ferrari friggin' flying around. I want to see that Ferrari going all over the place, right? So he agrees to the fact that we do not like training, one-on-one training. We do not do one-on-one training in our system. Maybe in rare cases, but we do not do one-on-one training. Everything is based off of 5-minute, 10-minute videos. Okay, because it's much more effective, it's much more efficient, they get documented, and then they move forward, right? Training is a four-letter word. We hate training. Training sucks because it's so ineffective. No one remembers it anyway, right? And you have to agree to follow the rest of the system as well. So he gets his virtual systems architect, and in a couple of days after the person starts, one of my guys does a little check-in we always do a little check-in, see how everything's going. And he starts, like, the first thing he says was, "Oh, things are going really well," which I was like, "Oh, that's great." He said, "I wish I would have had, some kind of pre-onboarding so that I didn't waste the day training this person." And I might have read that wrong. I could have totally read it wrong, how he said it, because maybe it was a little bit, I'm not sure. I could have totally read it wrong, and I could be totally, as I'm on this podcast, I could be totally 100% mistaken in what he's saying. Hey, but I'm so protective of what I've built. I'm so protective of what I built, and we have such a large queue of people who are waiting for their VSA that I want to work with those people who absolutely 100% get it. And so part of his question was, "I wish there was a pre-onboarding so I didn't spend most of the day getting her up to speed. I hate that because it means you're training, because typically what customers do is they will have 5-minute videos that they've already done, like maybe, you know, 5-10 of them already done, and they hand them off to the VSA. The VSA documents all of those in the first few days and then says, "Okay, go ahead and start doing bop, 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 bop." So in the first week, they're already doing real work without having to go back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, and train and spend a day training or anything like that. So I'm like, as soon as I see that, I'm like, "Oh boy, oh great. This is not what I wanted. And so he comes, a couple of other questions were things like, you know, what did they do before working for ProSulum? What are their skill set? What are their specialties? What's their specialty? And so, you know, these are things that, so what did they do before ProSulum? We send bios to these people before they even accept them as their VSA, like detailed bios on what they've done in the past and everything like that. Questions that where I'm like, why is this being asked again? That doesn't make sense. And then especially when I personally see what is their specialty, then I'm like, okay, you don't get it. You definitely don't get the system, because who the heck cares about specialties in our system? Because who we hire are blank slates who literally can clone you. And that's a big part of our onboarding process, is a big part of our philosophy, a big part of all of that. So I immediately look at all that and I go, he does not understand the system. And so I write back this whole thing. answering all of his things. And I say at the very end, I'm totally open to scheduling a refresher call with you. You can use this calendar right here. You can use the calendar here to make that happen. However, I'm going to have, essentially what I said was, I'm going to have my team check in on you next week. And if it looks like the system's not being followed, then I also asked, like, how many process videos have you created for them to document? But I said, if by, you know, next week, if it looks like the system's not being followed, I'm going to have to cancel and refund. Okay. And said it in a nice way. I think I did, at least. And he, you know, he wrote back and he said, oh, I don't think you're going to have to cancel and refund. These were just questions. And it's true. They were just questions. But they're questions they're questions that show that something is not being understood. A big part, I mean, the inside, because imagine if I'm trying to think of a good analogy. Imagine if you are, imagine if you're working at McDonald's or Burger King and someone comes up to the counter and says, hey, do you guys have a pasta fagiorno? Do you guys have a penne rustica? Do you guys have, you know, any hollandaise sauce? Hey, do you guys have a Whopper here? You're working at McDonald's, so do you have a Whopper? You're gonna immediately think, wait, this person like is totally confused. Like, this person is either playing a prank on me or does not realize that they're at McDonald's, doesn't know anything about McDonald's, right? So yeah, they might be questions, and they are. They might be questions, but they're very telling questions. And so, going to a Ferrari dealership, you're not going to say like Lamborghini and Ferrari. From what I've been told, that you have to sign an agreement. You have to sign like things saying that you will not do certain things. You will not drive it in certain ways. You'll not do this. You'll not do that. And they're very serious about who buys their cars. You don't go. So if you went to a Ferrari dealership and you said, "Hey, how do you deal with people with bad credit?" Immediately, they're gonna look at you and go, "Yeah, I don't think I want to work with you." Right? No, it's just a question. It's just a question. So you go up and you say, "Hey, do you work with people who've trashed other Ferraris and Lamborghinis?" They're gonna look at you and go, get out. And you're gonna say, "Oh, it's just a question." These questions are very, very telling. And so when I heard these, I'm like, I don't think this is going to be a good fit. I wonder if Luna's up there. I've not seen Luna in a while. Anyway. I'll give it another shot, but it might be, and it's fine. I even said, you know, if no hard feelings, you know, iron sharpens iron. If it's not a good fit, it's not a good fit. But it might be where we have to part ways. So what is the whole purpose of this? Why am I sharing this? I'm sharing this because you should never be, it's very hard not to be in a mode where you want to take everybody in as a client. And the thing about it is that you got in this for a reason, right? Business for a reason. And a lot of the times it was to not work for a boss who was just constantly, getting in your face, not work for a company that's just annoying and boring. You wanted to be able to use your skill sets, right? Well, you should never put yourself in the same situation with a customer who does not appreciate what you're giving them. Even if they understand the system, even if they understand what you're doing, if they're not appreciative, and if it's not a relationship where it's back and forth, mutual respect, then often it's better just to cut it. Often it's better not to have that relationship because it causes stress. It causes, I literally was writing that email. It took half hour of my time, 20 minutes of my time, and my time is extremely valuable. And so that in and of itself, like that, shows that it's that this relationship is already making it so I'm not able to give the value to them that they need to my other clients that they need because I'm getting stuck with answering someone whom I might be, like I said, I might be totally mistaken. However, from the onset, from what I saw and from what I see, looked as though they did not understand what the system was, and so it made it a very tenuous situation. So you never want to be in that situation, okay? I know I've went longer than most of the other podcasts like this, but it's a very, very important thing, all right? Same thing goes with relationships. Don't be in a relationship with someone that constantly is not giving value, right? Doesn't understand you, doesn't want to understand you. That's a recipe for disaster. So this week, just think about some of the things, whether it's a client or relationship, something that you're in where you feel like that they obviously don't understand you, or they don't understand what's going on, and do something about it. It might be cutting, it might be just talking about it, it might be just raising up and communication. Okay. But don't work with people that you don't want to work with. All right, this is Dean Soto with Freedom in 5 Minutes. Go check out freedominfiveminutes.com. Also, check out prosulum.com, prosulum.com. Got some awesome stuff there if you want to. Actually, I created a course there as well. It's a four-video series course. If you go to prosulum.com and you try to leave, there is a pop-up that comes up for a four-video series course that you can join. It's actually really good. It shares all my secrets when it comes to systems and also virtual systems architects, things like that. So go check that out as well. So prosulum.com. All right. So this is Dean Soto. Freedom in 5 Minutes. I'll catch you in the next Freedom in 5 Minutes podcast episode.
Thanks for listening to the Freedom in 5 Minutes podcast. Now, head over to www.freedominfiveminutes.com and register for our free masterclass and discover how to start systemizing and automating your entire business 5 minutes at a time. We'll see you next time on the Freedom in 5 Minutes podcast.